Coming up on today's episode of Airborne Affordable Flyers, DirectFly delivers 200th Alto LSA. Rotax publishes service bulletin for all 915i and 916i engines. Risen 916 ISV heading for Oshkosh the hard way. And I'm your host, Holland Lee. Welcome to Airborne Affordable Flyers, our programming designed to help you get and stay in aviation as affordably as possible. Overseen by the editorial staff of the award-winning Sport Plane Resource Guide, we know well the challenges faced by today's sport flyers, and we're here to help you enjoy flying to the utmost. Let's get into today's stories. DirectFly delivers 200th Alto LSA. Czech sport plane manufacturer DirectFly has finished delivering its 200th Alto NG, the latest iteration of their 600-kilogram sport plane. The Alto was previously offered as the Alto 912 TG model, sporting some light tweaks and changes for improved stiffness and durability. One such modification added additional engine space up front, shifting the weight a tad to prevent the TG's habit of tail standing when disembarking. The newer ones also make full use of the 15-kilogram baggage compartment, with improved engine performance, intake, and cooling. Improvements to riveting points, welds, and fixtures help to streamline the build for those who complete their own sport plane too. The Alto NG uses a Rotax 912 ULS and Galaxy GRS rescue system, with seating for two abreast and enough legs for a respectable cross-country cruiser. Overall, the Alto NG is a pretty familiar collection of ingredients, offering buyers a simple, low-wing, tricycle-geared two-seater with a solid blend of aerodynamic and robust design to allow its construction from a quick build or standard build-it-yourself kit. For the impatient, DirectFly is happy to offer it in a fully built, ready-to-fly spec too, with many of the niceties already installed, like electric flaps, electric trim, and hydraulic brakes with a panel to order. After the break, UAvionics AV Link receives FAA approval.
Fellow pilot, I'm John King.
And I'm Martha King.
You know, we've all had our flying lives disrupted lately.
Well, King Schools is here to help you stay up to date with courses that you can access on your desktop, iPad, or iPhone. If you'd like a refresher or just want to expand your aviation horizons, we have a course for you.
So head over to kingschools.com/rusty today for details.
Welcome back. Now let's take a trip around the patch for some shorter stories. UAvionics AV Link receives FAA approval. Following months of collaboration, UAvionics has received FAA approval of the AV Link for certified aircraft. This approval expands the available functionality of UAvionics' ecosystem of AV30 panel displays, sky sensor, and portable ADS-B receivers, and transforms how these devices work with each other to display data for enhanced situational awareness and pilot efficiency in the cockpit. The AV-Link, a Wi-Fi companion module for the AV30, enables the display of non-certified ADS-B traffic data on certified avionics instruments. Does simming make a better student pilot? The Flight Simulation Association completed a survey of pilots and air traffic controllers across the country, looking to quantify the exact impact of home-based flight simulation on their resulting training. The association found that for private pilot students, those who use the flight sim saved about 5.5 hours of training time, not too shabby when Skyhawk time seems to settle around $150 an hour across the country. Throughout their training, the survey found that active flight sim enthusiasts got their certificate almost 20 hours faster than the national average. World Games to include drone racing. The World Games 2025 schedule for drone racing has been published, with the big 32-man race scheduled to take part from August 14th to 16th. The races will be held at the Dong'an Lake Sports Park in Chengdu, China, pitting 32 competitors through a ringer of FPV speed racing. The proposed schedule also adds a day prior to the competition start for model processing, so pilots have a chance to walk through the track, practice, and prep their gear after a long flight to China. 2024 AMA National Fun Fly, barely a month away. The upcoming 2024 AMA National Fun Fly will be quite a celebration. It's planned to be a combination of a traditional fun fly and a community day, and it being a free event doesn't hurt the prospects at all for the community of model aviation enthusiasts. AMA notes that the vision for the 2024 AMA National Fun Fly set for June 28 through 30th is to foster a renewed spirit for model pilots with enhanced community engagement. They envision this event being a dynamic activity that celebrates the thrill of model aviation, yet one that highlights the importance of nurturing the next generation of aviators. That's it for today's trip around the patch. Let's get back to the rest of the news. Rotax publishes service bulletin for all 915i and 916i engines. The Rotax folks have published a service bulletin after issues were noted that may affect all 915i and 916i series engines. Rotax operators have reported occasional, isolated cases of a momentary slipping of the overload clutch, which may lead to a slight exceedance of the maximum RPM limit, followed by the engine RPM quickly normalizing. Rotax describes the overspeed event whereby the engine speed setting is actually between 5,500 and 5,800 RPM at wide open throttle stabilized, quote, followed by a sudden overspeed up to 6,500 RPM for less than a second. The clutch increases its transmittable torque during slipping conditions and synchronizes the engine speed with the propeller again, which consequently led to an undercut of the engine speed down to 4,000 RPM, followed by a recovery of the initial engine setting between 5,500 and 5,800 RPM. The entire event is lasting up to 3 seconds. In rare cases, if upper sequence happens more times than identified, the transmittable torque of the overload clutch will be reduced, and the speed fluctuation just can be stabilized by a slight reduction of the throttle down to 96%. If the engine speed has stabilized, the throttle setting could be increased to WOT again, end quote. And after these messages, Risen 916 ISV heading for Oshkosh the hard way.
Backcountry flying to us is our playground. For us, it's how we access the things we like to do. It's just our lifestyle. We exclusively use the Hartzell Voyager prop, and it's proved to be just a great combination for what we do. What it's doing, it's helping us all have better performing airplanes. Man, it feels a lot better clearing trees by 50 feet versus 20 feet. I don't ever see myself not flying.
Welcome back. Risen 916 ISV heading for Oshkosh the hard way. In perusing over 1,000 variations of sport aircraft for the current Sport Plane Resource Guide, a few designs definitely catch the eye. One of the most startling of these is an all-composite V-tail machine that appears to offer an extraordinarily low drag coefficient, along with a big bubble canopy and wide side-by-side seating. The Risen 915i SV has now been upgraded to the Risen 916i SV, and one of those is shortly going to be leaving Italy and flying all the way to Oshkosh, including the arduous trip over the North Atlantic. The numbers for this aircraft are incredibly impressive, and the 915-powered versions are pushing 200 knots in a big way. But the sleek design offers so little drag that it doesn't take a whole lot of power to demonstrate some extraordinary performance. The airplane is one of the top 5 on Jim Campbell's must-fly list for Oshkosh 2024, and we greatly look forward to flying it. If it flies as well as it looks, this could be a major player in the sport plane industry's future. In the meantime, Risen's Andreas Venturini and Alberto Porto committed themselves to the aforementioned long-distance The Challenge flight from Italy to Oshkosh several weeks ago, and we look forward to seeing them at Whitman Field. And that's our show for today. You can catch episodes of Airborne on YouTube, Roku, or Fire TV. Just search for Aero News or Airborne, and don't forget to follow us on social media. Thanks for watching!